This technique is for hip abduction, external rotation, and hip extension. So it's designed to reduce people collapsing into that hip adduction, internal rotation, and that dynamic valgus at the knee. And we're seeing some of the emerging research showing that it does just that. It can reduce the velocity and the magnitude of that collapse into hip adduction and internal rotation. So it may be indicated in a range of different people. We're seeing some research emerging on greater trochanteric pain syndrome, but it might be some of our ACL repair reconstruction subjects. It could be even some of our medial shin soreness and so on. Anyone where we're looking at controlling that frontal plane motion of the hip essentially, but here we're also going to control some of that sagittal plane or absorb some light in the sagittal plane as well, so they don't need to collapse across in that frontal plane. So we need to get the person into that shortened position. So we have Erin take a step forward with her left foot. We're going to tape up the right one. So we then turn the foot out into external rotation, and we maximize that by rotating the hips forward. And then if we shift the hips to the left, we will get abduction of this right hip as well. And this is a spiral technique. So we're going to start on the thigh, sweep around so that we get good purchase on that lever, on that leg, and we can actually get some mechanical effect on it. Then we're going to carry on over and across and finish on the contralateral iliac crest or pelvis, essentially. So we have start on an angle up the limb so you can spiral around. Nice large anchor point so we don't run into blisters. If you just shear on there, you will get a blister, so do make sure you hold that really well. Get your tension on as we sweep around the leg to get hold of that lever. Keep your tension on as you remove your backing paper. And the key here is that we need to come up behind the axis of the hip joint. So Erin, if we just turn you to turn it all the way around, just step around. Yep, so we just change position so we can see. Yep, and now pop your right leg back once again. Okay, so now what we need to do is make sure that we're coming up here behind the hip joint. If we come too high over here, we won't get any length change in flexion, so we won't get a hip extension moment. So it's got to really got to come quite low across the hip and then lock off with a nice anchor point on this other side. And so what we will see then, if Erin, if you stand up for me and just try to take your knee up to your chest, we'll see that this is resisting that hip flexion and assisting back into extension, abduction, external rotation. If we miss that line and we come too high, if you pop your leg back once again, that way, yep. And if we come to, even if we're in the short position, but we come up high, now if you go to step through, okay, we've lost that length change. We don't get that hip extension moment being generated. So we're losing some of that mechanical effect. So by coming behind, it means we get that nice mechanical effect there. That's right, come up. So actually, as the person goes down, if you try and do a little one-legged squat on your right, just a little, that's it. That's going to help control that hip flexion and therefore help reduce the likelihood that they're going to collapse in that frontal plane as well.